गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न्ड अबाउट माइक्रो मोर अबाउट पेंट इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास, राइट? आई हैड शेयर्ड अ वीडियो फॉर द सेम. नाउ टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू समथिंग प्रैक्टिकली अबाउट द पेंट. सो लेट्स ओपन अ पेंट विंडो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. इन दिस पेंट विंडो यू कैन सी इट इज अ देर इज अ ब्लैंक प्लेस ओवर हियर, अ ब्लैंक पेज. And the background of this page is white. Okay, so you can change the color of the background from over here. This is the background color and this is the foreground color. Whatever we'll be drawing over here will be coming from this foreground of black color. Let me add few of the shapes or images over here, just like a circle or this image or whatever you want. You can add so many images or figure over here, right? Got it? In this way. Now today we are going to learn about a select tool. Here this is a select tool. If you are going to view window, you will not get the select tool. You have to go to the home window. In the home, the image group, this one, see here, image it is written, okay? So image group, in that the select one. When I'm clicking on the select tool, you will get so many options. First is rectangular selection, then freeform selection, select all. And you can see that invert selection and delete, both of these options are disabled at present. This can be enabled afterwards, and there is a transparent selection also. Okay, so let us start with the rectangular selection. If I am clicking on the rectangular selection, and then you can see the cursor has been converted into a plus sign. Okay, I want to select this circle, so by a rectangular selection. So in this way I will select this one. Okay, so this is a rectangular selection. If I am going to select the free form selection, this one, so whatever part you want to select, you can select in a free way. You can move your cursor in the same way over here, okay, and you can move it like this. I'm showing it again, the free form selection. I have selected this, okay. Similarly, I can select over here also, wherever I want to. If I want to select the whole part, I can select the whole part also like this. Got it? This is the free form selection. Then select all. If I am clicking on this, then the whole window gets selected. See, whole page got selected. You can see the broken line over here. That shows that this whole page is got selected. Now, what does this help you? Why do you want to select it? If you want to cut an image, if you want to cut and paste it somewhere, or else if you want to delete something, then also you can do this thing. Okay, select option, a rectangular selection. Now again, see, I want to delete this much selected part. I want to delete, so I have selected this. I will go here, and you can see now this invert selection and this delete option, both these options were disabled before this. Now these options have become enabled, and now I can delete this. Why? Because I have selected this one. If I am not going to select this one, see these options will get again disabled. Yes, so I'm showing you how to delete this. I've selected this one, going over here, delete option, and the bottom part has went off, right? Again, now if I'm going to do this freeform selection, I've selected this much part. Now I don't want this much part, so what I will do, I will delete it. Got it? But what if I want the selected part to stay and the rest of the part to be deleted? See, now I am selecting this much of part. I want this much part, the selected part, to stay in my window, and this rest of the part should go off, should be deleted. Then what I will do, I will select the invert selection option, this one. So that, and after that, if I will delete, the rest of the part goes off and the selected part remains on the screen. Hope you have got it. Okay, so this we have learned. Now I want to take this image from over here. Let me select the rectangular section over here. Okay, I want this much part to be cut and pasted somewhere else. Okay, so I have selected this. See, in the home, the clipboard group, you can see cut option is there. Yes, I will click on that cut option, so this part has been cut off. Now I want to paste it somewhere. So what I will do, I will directly click on the paste option. You can see whenever you are cutting and pasting, it always appears on the top left corner of your screen. Now you can move wherever you want to move. I want to move it over here, I can move it over here. I want to move anywhere, wherever you want to move, you can move it and paste that option. And you can paste it if it is already selected. Once you deselect this one, you won't be able to move. See, now I won't be able to move this one. Right? Got it, all of you? After that, so we have learned about the cut, copy and paste. Now, before that, let us see about the color, the background color. See, whenever I'm moving any object, the background color replaces the background color of the page. At present, we have the background color as white. That is why this portion is replaced by white color. But if I'm changing the background color, take for an example, the orangish color, okay. Now, if I am going to select any option and cut it, okay, let me select this option, this much part, and I will cut this one, okay. So, when I am cutting it, the background color changes that much part into orange color. If I am going to move also, then also the same thing will happen. Let me take a free form selection and I want to move this much part. Then also, when I'm moving this much part, then also you will get that the background color is replaced by the color which we have selected over here. Got it? You can also change this foreground color by clicking on this foreground color, clicking on any color that you want. Let us select pink color, okay? And an object, and see, the foreground color has changed to pink. Now, what if I don't want any of these images on any of these objects? Then what I'll do is I want to import a picture that is already there in my PC, in my computer. So I will go to this clipboard group. In that, the paste, there is a small arrow over here. I click on that arrow, then the paste from option I'll select. Which one? The paste from option. When I am clicking on the paste from option, you are getting so many options over here. In that, I will go to the pictures. Okay. And here I have got a folder called sample pictures. I'll open that one from selecting over here and then open. When I'm opening this folder, you can see there are lot many options, whichever picture you want. Okay. Let us use this penguin images. Right. And then open. You have got this picture over here. Now this picture is very big in size. I want to resize it. How will I resize? See here, the resize option and rotate option. Both the options are there in the image group. Yes. So here already this image is selected. How you came to know? Because you can see the broken lines around this image. Right? So this image is already selected. Now I will click on resize. You can resize this image in two ways. One is percentage and other is pixels. Okay. If I am changing the value over here from 100 to, let's say, 10, and I'll press click OK. So the image will turn in the smaller size. Okay. Similarly, if I'm selecting the pixels, okay, and supposingly you can do anything in horizontal or vertical, no matter. If I'm converting these pixels from 77 to, say for example, 400, and then I'm clicking on OK. So the image has also again increased in size. Now there is one more option over here, skew in degrees. That we'll see afterwards. Before that, let me show you how to rotate this image. You can rotate or flip this image. Okay, you can see this penguin, the middle one is looking on this side. Okay, if I want to flip it vertically, it will flip in this way. Okay, if I want to flip it horizontally, it will flip in this way. Got it? Similarly, if I want to rotate 180 degree, it is again rotating. If I want to rotate it left 90 degree, so it will rotate on the left side in a 90 degree. If I want to rotate in right 90 degree, it will rotate in right 90 degree. So where in whichever way you want, you can rotate your images. Now we can see, let me get the original image. Okay, let me get back that original image from the paste from that penguins open. Okay, this original image I got back. Now there is one more option of skew here. This skew in degrees, that means you can tilt your image in few of the degrees. At present it is straight. See, this image at present is straight. Now I want to tilt this image horizontally, so I will to a degree of say 50. Okay, 50 degree I am tilting it, and then okay. So you can see this image has been tilted to 50 degrees, right? Similarly, if I want to tilt it horizontally, you can go to resize, then vertically if I want to tilt it, then over here 50, and then okay. See, this image is tilted now vertically as well as horizontally. Now I'm not happy with my picture and I want the original picture back. What I will do? Again, I'll import that picture? No, I won't. What I will do? I will undo this option. How you will undo? From here, see, on the top bar over here, you can, you have two arrows. One is over here and the other is over here. If you are putting an arrow over here, you are getting this option of undo. Okay, so if I'm clicking once, only one time that will get, that will be revert back. If I am clicking on the other arrow, you will get that one, this option back. Okay, that is undo and the other one is redo. This one is undo and this one is redo. This one is undo, this one is redo. Redo means you get your things that you had done well, you will get that back, and while doing undo, you will get the previous screen back. Hope this is clear to all of you. Now children, what I want is, I want this picture to see it properly. Okay, if I am adding this picture again, okay, this is smaller in size. Now I want this picture to just see. I don't want this picture, I want the picture in the same size, but I want to see in a zoomed view. Okay, I want to zoom in. So how will I do? See, next to home there is a view option. I will click on that. In that there are two options, zoom in and zoom out. If I am clicking on zoom in, the whole of this picture, whole of this window gets zoomed in. So see, if I'm clicking on this, you can enlarge your picture over here. See, more and more you can enlarge. But when I'm clicking on zoom out, you can diminish that picture. See, this is zoom out, and again zoom out. This is zoom in, right? Zoom in and zoom out. Now going back to the home over here. Now you are satisfied with your picture, and now what you want? You want to save your picture. You want this picture to be saved. What I will go? I will directly click over here and save the picture. Okay, and let me put some name over here, as in whatever to put, picture. Okay, I'm putting a picture and then save. So this picture is saved now. Now what I want, see, at present my desktop background is of Windows over here. What I want is, I want my background to be this picture. So how will I set it? I will go to this one, a paint window, a small one. Okay, here the arrow is there. I'll click on that arrow, and when I will scroll down, you will reach to an option, set as desktop background, right? Set as desktop background. On the desktop background, you will get three options. One is fill, tile, and center. As you can see over here in the fill, the whole of this window gets filled with it. Okay? In the tile option, the same picture is can be seen as a tiles. While in the center, the picture comes at the center. Let us first of all see the center option. Okay, I'm selecting this center option and see my desktop background will be at the center. Similarly, if I want to set as a tile, set as a tile or fill option, you can set in a way that you want to do. Okay, So that's all for today. I hope everything is clear to you all, and thank you, and have much practice.